What is it? What's going on?
It's the commanding officer, sir. He was found dead in his quarters.
Thank you, I think. After 6 years, this may be the first time you have ever gotten us coffee. What are you up to? And why so many cups?
I've been closely studying the mysterious ways of the boss man this past week. I think the secret to his genius may be in the coffee, so I've decided to go toe-to-toe with Gibbs today. Just the two of us, mano-a-mano, in a coffee-slurping showdown, and I'm stocking up for the challenge.
Thanks, Dinozzo. Gibbs. Grab your gear.
Where are we going, boss?
Iraq. What do we got?
The victim is a Caucasian male, late 40s, Captain J.J. Husker.
Tell me you got more than that, Ziva.
Not much. Just that until his death, he was the commanding officer at this base. McGee is pulling the rest of his records now.
Look for signs of a struggle. Ziva, you check the office. Where's Dinozzo?
He is outside. I do not think he feels well.
Too much coffee.
Lightweight.
All right, we're gonna play as Gibbs. Signs of a struggle. Captain J.J. Husker.
Jethro, I need your assistance. We need to turn the victim on his side. Ah, very interesting. Quite a unique tattoo. This is strange. This wound is quite large, but there is very little blood under the body.
Must be somewhere. I'll find it. How far can a pool of blood get? Wardrobe. Good place to hide something. Looks like the base of something larger.
Broken furniture and the general disarray of the room indicates a physical fight took place here. Good job, buddy.
Someone clearly dragged something across the floor. And would you look at that?
Something was dragged across here, and that looks like blood.
Like a body?
Looks like a broken chair. One leg missing.
I guess the captain had a rough night.
He sure did. He was drunk and missed the chair.
Oh, my stomach. Not liking that much coffee.
What a wimp.
Something over there. Gotta move this couch first. Get on the other end.
Yes, Gibbs.
Man, you can't move a couch by yourself? What a wimp.
It looks like a broken chair leg. Ziva, you find something out there?
Nothing yet. I'm almost finished with the bookshelf, but I've not gotten to the desk yet.
I'll do it. A broken flag stand. That's all I needed. Gotta get in there. I need to get a photo of these documents. Looks like fingerprints.
Abby will do that.
Someone mop this floor. Looks like someone tried to clean up some blood.
Seriously, nothing else?
Traces of blood. It was used to clean some kind of mess.
Missing. Maybe on the body. I gotta take a shot. Go find out. No. Need more blood, so
did you check the desk?
Won't let me. Has to be in the bathroom. On this dirt. That's horrible.
I'm not feeling so good. I'm just gonna stay over here by the bathroom.
Seriously, what am I missing? Thank you.
Did you check the desk?
I can't.
Did you check the desk? Did you check the desk?
Oh lordy, this is horrible. I don't know what I'm missing. I really don't. It's almost like it's in here. Check the desk, but I can't. Can't change angles, not that I know of. Give me a second, guys. Alright, sorry about that, guys. I had to get a bottle for the baby.
Did you check the desk?
Desk. Wait.
Blood. That's all of it.
The blood on the captain's desk. Is it from the victim?
You can look around, but I can't let you remove the captain's body.
This is a murder investigation, Commander. Gotta do an autopsy.
I'm sorry, Agent Gibbs, I really am, but orders are orders. I'm sure you understand.
Whose orders?
The acting CO, Commander Premis.
Premis. No clue who that is. I'll take that trophy. Oh, now the boring puzzles.
Gotcha.
And yes, these are very boring. Pretty much just lining up everything, holding it down, rotating with L2 and R2. Fingerprints on this document belong to the acting CO, Commander Promise.
You can try to hide from Abby Shudo, but all you can do is try. I've found nanoparticles.
God, she looks so weird on this.
Microbes living on needles inside haystacks. I can find you, and I will. Oh, yes, I will. Gibbs, there's only one set of prints on the folder you sent. They belong to Commander Premis, the acting CO.
All right, let's do a deduction board.
Over the phone?
Yep.
Usually Gibbs here for this part.
Let's see what we can find.
But we'll do it ourselves.
What is it I'm looking for anyway?
Why do you think that, Abs?
Okay, check this out.
Someone used a mop to clean up the bloodstains in Captain Husker's office. But
why do you think that, Abs? In English, Abs.
Let me read it more.
That's supposed to make sense, Abs?
No, I'm just screwing up.
In English, Abs.
I deserve a cupcake for that.
Sure. Even though I picked every answer but the correct one.
Time to earn your lab coat. This won't elude me for long. Whoever murdered Captain Husker fought with him first. Then once he was dead, they tried to clean up the room.
Ducky's got to examine that body. Thanks, Ab.
Dr. Sophia Marks, I'm Dr. Mallard, NCIS.
Hello, Dr. Mallard. I imagine you're here about the captain's death.
Yes, indeed. And if you wouldn't mind, I'd like to assist you with the autopsy.
I'd be honored. Your reputation precedes you. But I'm afraid that's impossible. The captain was involved in a classified mission, and I've been ordered not to let anyone near the body until he's been cleared.
Oh, my. I suspect Agent Gibbs will have something to say about that. I also suspect it won't be something nice.
I don't doubt it. Agent Gibbs has a reputation as well.
Yes, I suppose he does. When did you first hear about the CO's untimely demise?
The morning after it happened. I was in my quarters when I was informed.
And how was that?
Commander Primus came to my quarters that morning and told me the news.
It appears as if the captain's body was moved.
Yes, it was.
Anything further you can add, my dear?
Commander Primus ordered Captain Husker's body moved as soon as he learned what had happened.
Bad commander.
What can you tell me about the acting CO?
Commander Primus? He's a good officer. He served his country honorably and admirably in this time of war.
With all due respect, that sounds like a well-practiced answer from someone who doesn't want to say anything disparaging about her XO.
The reality is Commander Primus is not all that well-liked on this base. His methods are, let's just say, not quite the same as Captain Husker's.
Am I to understand Commander Primus is the cause of some tension here on base?
Look, it's chaos here. Our boys are getting shot at every day. Outside the base, they never know where the enemy is going to be hiding. So they depend on their lives inside the base to be, well, static. They don't want there to be enemies inside the base as well.
Forgive me saying so, but it sounds as if you yourself don't trust Commander Primus.
I never distrusted him before, but on the morning of Captain Husker's death, I saw Commander Primus take some files out of the open safe and tuck them under his field jacket. I don't know what he took, but just from the way he was acting, well, that's not something a trustworthy man would do.
Yes, I can certainly understand that. Well, I suspect you've had enough of my idle chatter.
Not at all. I'm glad to have had the opportunity to talk to you. I'm up for transfer to another base, and it could come through any day. I'm almost embarrassed to admit it, but I was hoping it wouldn't happen until later in the week so I could meet you.
You flatter me. Well, thank you for your time.
Oh, one sec, guys. Door.
McGee, I need you to run a background on the acting CO here.
Sure. What's his name?
Commander Benjamin Primus.
On it.
All right, apologize about that. More horrible puzzles. Just click on one as they pop up. That's it. Look through them and find the one with the yellow writing.
Interesting. Commander Primus was once disciplined for taking a swing at Captain Husker. Disciplinary records indicate that the two men were frequently at each other's throats. My guess is these guys didn't like each other much. Primus and Husker were at odds several times before.
You want me to do a deduction board?
You think, McGee? Yeah, I want you to do a deduction board.
Time to make some magic. That can't be right.
Fingerprints on the documents, actions.
But wait, there's more. That can't be right. In addition, it boils down to this.
Back to McKee, or Gibbs.
Gibbs, Commander Primus ordered Husker's quarters cleaned up after the body was found. And he's got motive. I think this is our guy.
Let's ask him.
Uh-oh. You in. Okay.
Commander Benjamin Primus?
Yes?
Special Agent Gibbs, NCIS. Got a few questions.
I have a base to run, Agent Gibbs. Perhaps we could do this another time?
And I'm investigating a murder. We do this now.
Very well.
Did you take something from Captain Husker's safe the night of the murder?
No.
Nothing at all?
No. Nothing.
Why'd you have fingerprints?
Dr. Marks saw you remove files from Captain Husker's safe. You calling her a liar?
Captain Husker has had a very high security clearance. He had sensitive files in his safe, ones that could have compromised the base and our mission here. I removed them before you arrived to avoid an unnecessary information leak. You can understand that along with the privilege to access classified information comes the responsibility to keep it safe at all costs.
What's your mission?
To educate and support the Iraqi police and defense forces in an ongoing effort to help stabilize their fledgling democracy.
You sound like a press release.
That is our stated mission, Agent Gibbs. If you have a problem with it, take it up with the Pentagon.
Did you order Dr. Marks to move the captain's body?
No.
No.
I don't like what you're insinuating.
Dr. Marks says you ordered the body moved.
I did order the body moved, but I did not order the doctor to move it.
You trying to cover up a murder?
What kind of man do you think I am?
Just answer the question.
No. I did not murder the captain, and I did not try to cover it up.
Ugh. Restart. I always forget to look at that arrow to the right. Now I gotta listen to talk again.
Commander Benjamin Primus?
Yes?
Special Agent Gibbs, NCIS. Got a few questions.
I have a base to run, Agent Gibbs. Perhaps we could do this another time?
And I'm investigating a murder. We do this now.
Very well.
Did you take something from Captain Husker's safe the night of the murder?
Captain Husker has had a very high security clearance. He had sensitive files in his safe, ones that could have compromised the base and our mission here. I removed them before you arrived to avoid an unnecessary information leak. You can understand that along with the privilege to access classified information comes the responsibility to keep it safe at all costs.
What's your mission?
That is our stated mission, Agent Gibbs. If you have a problem with it, take it up with the Pentagon.
Did you order Dr. Marks to move the captain's body?
I did order the body moved, but I did not order the doctor to move it.
You trying to cover up a murder?
No. I did not murder the captain, and I did not try to cover it up.
Why was the crime scene tampered with?
The man was a hero. He bravely served his country with honor. I just wanted to give him a little dignity. I didn't want anyone to see him face down with his head smashed in. He deserved better than that. So I gave him his dignity back. I ordered a soldier to move the body and tidy up the room. He got a little overzealous, but this was not an attempt to hide anything.
You and Captain Husker get along?
We were professional, respectful. I considered him my friend.
It has to be this one.
Usually throw punches at your friends, Commander Primus?
I am a professional Special Agent Gibbs. I follow my orders and accept the judgments of my superior officers. Captain Husker made me into the man I am today, and for that I am eternally grateful. I may have made some mistakes that I am not very proud of, but that does not change the fact that I respected and admired the captain.
Where were you the night the captain was killed?
After dinner in the mess, I was engaged with base business.
That it?
I was up late on a video conference call with Naval Command Operations in the U.S.
All right, Commander Primus, we're done here. Commander Primus has an alibi. Need you to confirm if he's telling the truth. And get me more background on Captain Husker.
You can count on me, boss.
This game puts me to sleep. I'd rather play a Telltale any day. Walking Dead, Tales from Borderlands, Batman. Probably gonna be doing Batman soon. This one you just match. Which looks to be one of the former SEAL team members of Huskers at the Caps, Crystal.
Well, boss, it looks like Commander Primus is telling the truth. But there's a watch commander, David Birch, there who shared service time with Husker. Maybe you can get something out of him.
Good work, McGee.
Commander Birch, got a minute?
I just got off duty. Anything I can do to help?
What can you tell me about the missions Captain Husker was leading?
Not a thing.
You were decorated for bravery, above and beyond the call of duty. It was on a mission Captain Husker was leading.
The details are classified. The operation is still ongoing.
Give me some help here, Birch.
Get a higher clearance and I'll tell you whatever you want to know.
We don't have time. You want me to get the guy who killed Captain Husker? You're gonna have to give me more than that.
What do you want to know?
What was the captain's last mission before he was killed?
We crossed the border into Iran.
Iran? Why?
It's called Operation Arrow. We were ordered to cross the border and either confirm or deny reports of an Iranian nuclear weapons program. But that's all I can tell you.
Your tattoo. It's the same as Captain Husker's. What does it mean?
It means we're badasses.
We got them together.
Let's hear it.
Only 10 men in the Navy have it. Just the men in our unit. It means you're one of us. We had them done just before deploying across the border.
Well, thanks for your help, Commander.
My pleasure.
Husker was in on deep cover black ops, possibly involving nuclear material. See what you can dig up on Operation Arrow.
I'll see what I can find.
I really hate having to click on his desk. Should just start you there. Really should. You just gotta pick the same ones in order. Car had a GPS, so I can track it wherever it goes. Let's do it.
Looks like the captain requisitioned a Humvee several times a week. Now all I need are the GPS records and we'll know where he's been.
This location is in Iraq, but our mission was across the border in Iran. There we go.
Hey, boss. It's hard to dig up much on Husker. Most of his records are sealed or classified.
You called to tell me you couldn't do your job?
No. Actually, I pulled his Humvee requisition records. He visits a location just outside a village not too far from the base.
And?
And there are no records of this location in any of his official reports.
I'll send someone to check it out.
Who is it going to be? Dinozzo? Most likely. We're getting sick.
This place looks like an abandoned warehouse.
From the look of things, I'd say nobody has been here for quite some time.
There's more than meets the eye here. Husker wasn't coming out here so he could reflect and think. He had to have a purpose.
Look up there, a door.
We've got to find a way up there. That other box is in the way. I can't move that box yet. I can't move that box right now. Help me move this, Ziva.
Where do you want it? Ready? Great. Now what?
Ziva, I need your help again.
Be happy to. Push.
Good job, Ziva. Let's move this box.
I am on it. go.
Piece of cake.
I can't move that box right now. Let's move this.
Be happy to. Pull.
Almost got it. I need to get this box over there.
Ah, now I see. Can you reach the rope?
I'll lift you up.
Not again.
Do you have a better idea?
All right, but no funny business.
I'll be a complete gentleman.
Sure you will.
Wasn't so bad now, was it?
I think you were the one who got all of the enjoyment, Tony.
How do we get up there?
Maybe we could use those planks. Maybe we could use those planks.
Help me move this, Ziva.
God, he's such a weakling.
I do not understand what it is you want to do.
Huh, now we can reach the door.
Someone has gone to great lengths to make sure we do not get inside that door. We should do our very best to disappoint them.
That is what I thought. Careful. Tony! Take my hand. I will pull you up.
Dude, they could just jump over that little gap.
Whew. I thought it was a goner. Thanks. How are we gonna get back?
We can find a way. That is not so very high.
Open sesame.
Torture room.
This place reminds me of a facility I would much rather forget.
Okay, we need to get pictures of everything. Ziva, bag and tag. Ducky, look for victims, or what's left of them.
I will check the other room.
There's a trap door here. Must lead to another room. This is padlocked. I'm gonna open it. Leads to a basement. Let's see what's inside. Let's go down.
Yes, let's. Hurry up.
Handcuffs.
think you should. I got it.
Shackles.
Piece of cake.
Let's go back up.
Who are you talking to? Come on, man.
Oh, that is gross. There's snot all over the inside of this bag.
I got it.
Cover his face.
A baseball bat?
Spikes.
That's just gross. Bat.
What else?
The door's locked. How do we get it open?
We need to find out what is on the other side of this door. Give me a hand getting it open.
Sure, Ziba.
It's locked. This looks like a gallows.
This is creepy.
I should take a picture of that, but it's too far away.
I can't get a photo of that from down here.
Get up there. Bring a wuss.
These look like torture instruments.
Piece of cake.
It's a battery?
That's a car battery.
Perfect.
There seems to be minute blood trails around the chair and several of the walls. These could be indicative of forced injections. You might want to keep your eyes open for syringes or serum vials.
Sure, Ducky, I'm on it. This looks like a torture chair. That's just gross.
That's what I keep saying. That's just gross. Oh my god. How could it be that way? It's disgusting.
That hole's too high to climb through. If only I could get up there.
By using the table.
Help me move this desk.
He doesn't ask, he just demands.
What do you hope to gain by moving this?
Trust me, Deckmeister. This seems like it's the right height.
I am no longer a young man. I don't think I could climb that far. You are going to have to do it.
Make him fall, please.
These look like something out of a medieval torture chamber. I should look for more.
Tony, don't keep us in suspense. Please, let us in.
Tony, Are you in there? Are you all right?
I'm coming. Hold on.
And presto, the door is unlocked. That's no dentist chair. Let's see what else we could find. The toilet tank. Good place to hide stuff. The toilet tank. Good place to hide stuff.
Seriously, you couldn't just pick that up and put it down?
Almost got it. There's something in the toilet. A vial.
These could be indicative of forced injections. You might want to keep your eyes open for syringes or serum vials.
Hey, here's a safe. Time to crack this baby. Bingo. Here's another vial, though whatever was inside doesn't appear to be the same as in the others.
It smells like urine. It smells like urine.
Well, yeah. Torture.
See the rope clearly now. I should take a picture.
Perfect.
Nice, Tony. Can you check with Ducky and see if he needs any help?
Did I miss? Guessing it's in this room or the other one. What did I miss, guys?
Nice, Tony. Can you check with Ducky and see if he needs any help?
That's good. Maybe I missed something.
Let's go down. Let's go back up.
I have no clue again.
Claw hammer.
I got it.
Boss, this place is straight out of a horror movie. Someone was torturing people here.
Well, maybe this will give us the leverage to examine Husker's body. Get back to the base.
Torture chamber. All right. I think we got it. 3 or 4 more trophies.
Doing better today. I'm already on number 3.
Good for you. Doc, autopsy. You started?
Will they allow me to see the body yet?
Vance is pulling the strings right now. Go get ready.
All right, I'm on my way.
Wait, how many cups has he had?
I cannot say for certain, though I believe he has just finished number 4.
Dinozzo's ultimate plan to be better than Gibbs. Drink more coffee.
What do you have to tell us today, young man? The victim has telltale signs of early-stage thyroid cancer.
Dead men really do tell tales.
Most likely caused by repeated exposure to radioactive material. It wasn't the cause of death, and I suspect the poor man didn't even know he had it. But despite the evidence, it was not the blow to the head that killed the poor man. His ultimate demise was cardiac arrest. This particular choice in body art is not something I have come across before. Of course, many sailors have some sort of tattoo on their bodies, and this one has elements that remind one of many other US naval-inspired sailors. Our captain obviously suffered massive head trauma. There are bruises and telltale wounds on his skull that suggest he was bludgeoned by a heavy object.
What am I missing? Why am I missing something every time? I'm getting old. One more. Ah, there it is.
The suspicious needle entrance on the man's back makes me think there is something we're missing. I'm going to send a sample of his blood to Abby for testing. The cancer we found is consistent with what you've told me about his mission history, but cardiac arrest, especially for a man of the captain's relatively young age and high level of fitness, is quite unusual. I've sent samples of his blood to Abby for testing.
Keep up the good work, Duck.
Blood sample. More matching.
The substance in Husker's blood is succinylcholine. In small doses, it is used to induce muscle relaxation. In larger doses... It's Abby. I just finished the tests on Captain Husker's blood. I found high levels of a toxin known as succinylcholine. In much smaller doses, it's used as a muscle relaxer, commonly used to induce paralysis for tracheal surgery.
All right, let's do another deduction board.
Abby's favorite thing. Here we go.
Let's see what we can find.
Gee.
Well, what does that mean, Abs?
Poison blood here. Comes with killed the bloated head. Probably poisoned to death. Husker.
Just what I thought. Husker's cause of death was definitely poison, not blunt force trauma or cardiac arrest. This was premeditated, cold-blooded murder.
Now we just need to know why.
I'm way ahead of you, working on the evidence you sent me now.
Could have just done the evidence before you called him.
Gotcha, you little bugger.
Little bugger. The unidentified fingerprints lifted from the torture tools found at the abandoned warehouse. Forensic analyst is needed. Oh, it's still me. Gee. Here we go. This one. For sure.
The fingerprints on these instruments belong to Captain Husker. Captain Husker was into something more than a little bondage. He was into full-on torture.
He said bondage. He's a dominatrix. Here, and the last one.
The substance in this vial is sodium pentothal, truth serum.
Vial B. Ugh, come on.
Fingerprints can tell a lot of stories. These are going to tell us who our killer is.
No. Shall I? Sorry. Oh, where's the fifth? Always do this. I don't go far enough right or not far enough down. but whatever.
Why would Dr. Marks be at the torture facility?
The
substance in this vial is succinylcholine, a highly toxic poison. Why does it not surprise me to find traces of a rare poison twice in one day? Gibbs, I found the same rare poison that killed Captain Husker in one of the vials from the torture facility. Those two are a long way apart. How did it get to both places?
Deduction board.
Let's see what we can find.
What does that mean, Abs? That's supposed to make sense, Abs?
Huskers. I don't remember what the other one is. Hold on. Fingerprints and sodium.
Why don't you explain it to me, Abs?
Found what we were looking for. So now it's clear. Husker was torturing people for information, and Dr. Marks was somehow involved. Then something went wrong between the two of them, and she poisoned him. Worried she'd get caught, she tried to frame the acting CO, Commander Primus.
Probably long gone by now. McGee, need to find the doctor. I'm already on it.
McGee? How long have you been on the line?
I'm always on the line.
Now this part is horrible too. I try to give it credit, but no. Gotta use this GPS thing and barely tap it. If you go too far, you lose a trace. And here we go.
Target on course to be intercepted.
We are right on top of you now, and in just a few moments, you'll be caught.
Target on course to be intercepted. Target headed east, heading 09er, Bravo 9er.
I've never missed before, and I don't plan to start now. I hope you've enjoyed your joyride.
Copy that. Target is outbound. We have a visual. Target headed east. Heading 09er, Bravo 9er. Target on course to be intercepted.
Oh,
crap. Target headed east. Heading
09er. Good job, McGee.
We got her, boss. The base guards are bringing her to you.
Got it.
Welcome back, Doctor.
I'm not telling you anything.
We know what you were doing out there, in that blood-stained concrete torture box.
You don't know anything.
As doctors, we took an oath to protect human life and limit suffering. I understand that sometimes those two goals conflict with each other.
You have no idea what you're talking about. This is a war zone, Dr. Mallard, not some comfortable morgue in Washington, D.C. Things work differently here.
I have spent more than my fair share of time in a war zone, Dr. Marks, and I once watched a man tortured to the brink of death repeatedly. It was my job to keep him alive so that his tormentor could extend his suffering. I refused and instead ended his suffering and his life. Much as I suspect you did for the victims out at that dreadful facility.
You have your facts wrong.
Why don't you correct me then?
I am a doctor. I save lives and end suffering. End of story.
You were torturing people at that warehouse.
No, never.
That's not good enough.
I would never intentionally inflict suffering on another human being. I'm not a torturer, Agent Gibbs.
More.
Saw the inside of your warehouse. We know what you and Husker were doing out there.
He ordered me. He made me inject them with sodium pentothal so they wouldn't resist his questions. Then he ordered me to nurse them back to health, just as Dr. Mallard described from his own experiences. He wanted to extend their pain. But I never tortured anyone. It was always Captain Husker. I did as I was ordered. I eased their pain, reduced their suffering as best I could.
Who were these people?
Iraqi civilians, mostly.
Need something more specific.
They were all Iraqi civilians. People he picked up off the street who he suspected as having ties to terrorists.
So you killed them?
I tried to help them.
Help them?
I didn't kill them. I did as I was ordered. I eased their pain, reduced their suffering as best I could.
We also found the succinylcholine.
No, it's not something... He was inflicting... terrible, unspeakable things. I couldn't let him keep doing that. Not to anyone. So I injected the succinylcholine instead of the sodium pentothal.
But he found out.
Yeah, he did.
So you killed him, too?
Yes, he found out. But no, I didn't kill him.
Welcome back, Doctor.
I got it wrong.
I'm not telling you anything.
We know what you were doing out there, in that bloodstained concrete torture box.
You have no idea what you're talking about. This is a war zone, Dr. Mallard, not some comfortable morgue in Washington, D.C. Things work differently here.
I have spent more than my fair share of time in a war zone, Dr. Marks, and I once watched a man tortured to the brink of death, repeatedly. It was my job to keep him alive so that his tormentor could extend his suffering. I refused, and instead ended his suffering and his life. Much as I suspect you did for the victims out at that dreadful facility.
I am a doctor. I save lives and end suffering. End of story.
You were torturing people at that warehouse.
He ordered me. He made me inject them with sodium pentothal so they wouldn't resist his questions. Then he ordered me to nurse them back to health, just as Dr. Mallard described from his own experiences. He wanted to extend their pain. But I never tortured anyone. It was always Captain Husker. I did as I was ordered. I eased their pain, reduced their suffering as best I could.
Who were these people?
They were all Iraqi civilians. People he picked up off the street who he suspected as having ties to terrorists.
So you killed them?
No, it's not something... He was inflicting terrible, unspeakable things. I couldn't let him keep doing that. Not to anyone. So I injected the succinylcholine instead of the sodium pentothal.
But he found out.
Yes, he found out. But no, I didn't kill him.
What exactly are you trying to say?
We know what you were doing out there, in that bloodstained concrete torture box.
You have no idea what you're talking about. This is a war zone, Dr. Mallard, not some comfortable morgue in Washington, D.C. Things work differently here.
I missed the button.
I have spent more than my fair share of time in a war zone, Dr. Marks, and I once watched a man tortured to the brink of death repeatedly. It was my job to keep him alive so that his tormentor could extend his suffering. I refused and instead ended his suffering and his life. Much as I suspect you did for the victims out at that dreadful facility.
I am a doctor. I save lives and end suffering. End of story.
You were torturing people at that warehouse.
He ordered me. He made me inject them with sodium pentothal so they wouldn't resist his questions. Then he ordered me to nurse them back to health, just as Dr. Mallard described from his own experiences. He wanted to extend their pain. But I never tortured anyone. It was always Captain Husker. I did as I was ordered. I eased their pain, reduced their suffering as best I could.
Who were these people?
They were all Iraqi civilians. People he picked up off the street who he suspected as having ties to terrorists.
So you killed them?
No, it's not something... He was inflicting terrible, unspeakable things. I couldn't let him keep doing that. Not to anyone. So I injected the succinylcholine instead of the sodium pentothal.
But he found out.
Yes, he found out. But no, I didn't kill him.
What exactly are you trying to say?
We know what
you have.
It was, I can skip it. You were,
then he or but I.
Who were
they?
See,
no, it.
Buddy.
Yes.
All right. So this one didn't work. Doesn't make sense to be that. Up to two. This one has to be.
Your autopsy proved that the commander was killed by a lethal injection of succinylcholine. You injected him. As he was dying, you hit him over the head to finish him off.
It wasn't like that. When he found out, he threatened me. Asked me if I wanted to trade places with one of the victims. I was scared. He came at me. I already had a syringe, so I injected him, but he was strong. He fought back.
What's the matter, Tony?
Oh, caffeine crash. I don't know how the Gibbs man does it, but if coffee is his secret weapon, count me out. I mean, I like coffee as much as the next guy, but Gibbs is inhuman.
How much did you lose by?
It doesn't matter how many more he drank than me, okay?
A lot. A whole lot.
Like you're one to talk. You don't even drink real coffee, just that little soft drink. I'd like to see you try to switch to a real man's brew. Then we'll see who's laughing.
You know, Tony, there's actually more caffeine in calf pow per ounce than in your typical cup of coffee. In fact, even with the latest coffee brewing technology, there is no way, either physical or chemical, to squeeze that much caffeine out of a coffee bean.
You'd have to artificially add caffeine to reach the same levels, and that's not even counting the ginseng, vitamin B, and other stimulants in calf pow.
Very nice, McGee.
So what are you saying?
They're saying you're the only one who can't hang with the boss.
Ugh.